Greetings, travelers! Today we are playing a Legend Yogg control deck made by Zaminator. He was able to snatch the number one Legend spot on the European server of the deck. Now let's have some fun. I've tested the deck prior to this recording a bit and it's pretty good. Going up against the Paladin here, we are keeping the Slam and the Acolyte of Pain here. Getting Harrison Jones, which is fine against the Paladin. And also a Shield Slam. The light protects me. There's a Squire, so he is most likely playing a Divine Aggro Paladin. But we will find that out. Just armor up here and then on turn 3 we will drop the Acolyte of Pain. Pointing into the Blood Knight, that will be now a 6-6. So the Blood Knight will now kill the Acolyte of Pain. No, he's going to the face. That is strange. So we can draw more cards out of the Acolyte of Pain. And hopefully getting an execute. As is Zavanna. So let's drop the taunt minion here. Inequality. He still wants to push 6 damage to the face. Reporting for duty. Not entirely sure about his place here. He will easily kill him now with the Acolyte of Pain, drawing another card. Getting a second bash, then let's drop the second Acolyte of Pain and take some armor here. Steward of Darkshire, that one will easily be killed. Either we are using the Bash or the Fury War Axe. Also getting an Execute, which is fine. I prefer the Bash at the moment. Then let's hit the minion here with the Slam. Drawing the Yogg-Theron already, and let's kill one of those. Draw another card, there's a Ravaging Ghoul. Should work out great against the Divine Paladin. Force Rider and the Divine Favor. So he is drawing 2, 3 cards, 4 cards. And stupidly just going to the face here again. So with the Ravaging Ghoul, we can easily clear the board here. We have 4, 6, 8, 9 cards in hand. So I'm not sure if I want to play the shield block as well. We are getting 2 cards out of the Acolyte of Pain here. So not playing the shield block at the moment. We are just dropping the War Axe and getting more armor. Doesn't look too good for the Paladin at the moment. We have options in hand that can deal with everything he's playing. Flame Juggler is not a problem here with the axe in hand. And if he's dropping too many minions, we have the Brawl, we have the Harrison Jones against his weapon. And of course we have good single target spells as well with the Execute and the Shield Slam. Another Brawl. Now let's play the Shield Block first. Might get another card that we want to play. Not the case. So we need to play something. And in this case we can just use the Bash here. For example, otherwise our hand would be too full. And of course, if we play more spells, the Yogg-Saron will get stronger on turn 10. If we like to drop him then. None may steal our surprise. Getting another shield block. And a revenge. With the blood we are able to clear both minions here. Getting more armor, and we could play the War Axe now. If we play the Yogg-Saron next turn, we have then also a weapon that we might get a buff. Leroy Jenkins hitting the face. Well, in this case, we will just kill him. I'd like to save the shield slam now, and let's play the Brave. Waiting with the Yogg-Saron. There's not much that the Paladin can do here. If he's putting out too many minions, we will brawl him, and that's why he's only playing a few. He has a handful of cards, so in general he should have many small minions. As a Blessing of Kings. Let's use the revenge here. And then the... or do we just use the shield slam? We could also use the Sylvana and then play the shield slam on the Sylvana and get the 5-5 here. Victory is yours. Oh, he's giving up. No chance for him. Game 2, Varia versus Druid. Let's see what we have here. A Slam, a Blood of Brave, Harrison Jones and a Brawl. Don't need the Harrison Jones here. The Brawl might not be helpful either. We're keeping the Slam and the Blood of Brave. We'll also go back to the deck. Hopefully drawing a Fury War Axe. There it is, also Shield Block and the Justicar True Heart. Raven Idol for the Druid on turn 1. Nice. And the Living Roots. No Ravaging Ghoul for us here. So let's kill one of the green saplings. Shapeshift and 2 to the face here. No problem at all. Playing the shield block here for sure. Gives us 5 more armor and there the Ravaging Ghoul. So we won't attack with the weapon here. Fendril might change our plan a bit. But we have the coins, so we can, you know, we can either use the shield slam here and then wait a bit, or we play the blood and the ghoul and then kill him. Shield slam might be too valuable against the druid. Also just use the slam here and then kill the Fendril. Lots of options. Let's use the slam. Keeping the ghoul for now. Another shield slam. And let's get more armor. If he's dropping more tokens later on in the game, the ghoul might be too valuable. So that's why we were using the slam here. Let's coin into the Justicar. Getting more armor here is very crucial right now if we have 2 shield slams in hand. They are only strong if we have enough armor. So if he's dropping Ancient of War on turn 7, we want to have at least 10 armor. Ooh, what is that? A summoning stone. And he's getting a dragon egg out of the summoning stone. So that one is unexpected. Inner Weight. Wisp and Power of the Wild. Interesting, interesting. So I guess we need to use the shield slam on the summoning stone here. Well, that was unexpected. Would use the shield slam here and play the ghoul, but then the dragon egg will spawn whelps, or we use the shield slam and the fiery war axe. Let's use it this way so we can kill the dragon egg next turn with the weapon and then play the ghoul. Might be We have no brawl, so that was pretty sad here in this situation. Also playing Violet Teacher now and a Feral Rage. Hitting us for more in the face, now down to 22. Still no brawl. We need to play the Ghoul here, as well as the Shield Slam. And the Blood will also kill the Wisp if we use it on the Wisp. So he has only one minion left. But we used a lot of resources here. Really would have loved to save a few cards. Dropping the swipe. And there with the bash. So he has four cards in hand. I guess I will just drop the Grommash here, kill his minion, and then go to the face next turn. If he allows us to. Rake will let him draw another card. And a Mulch. Getting all the good stuff here. And we are getting a... Ooh. Alright. Poison Blade. Not the best outcome. But we might push it a lot if we use the hero power here. Rage Unbound might be used next turn. Ooh, Wisp of the Old God. And he's killing our Malkorok. So a brawl would be pretty nice. We get the Oxaron here. So we might want to play it. If we have the Power of the Wild, that will be pretty bad next turn. So let's drop the Oxaron, hope for the best. Looks like we're getting an inner weight. There's a Curse of her farm. Mortal Strike. Claw. Explosive Trap is very good. Ambush will be shuffled into his deck. That's the inner weight. And that's it. Okay. So the Power of the Wild would only give the minions +1/+1. So not the worst. Explosive Tap will then kill all his minions. Of course, if he has another Wisp of the Old God in hand, that would be bad. Pay attention, class. As a Violet Teacher, dropping the Curse card and going to the face, so the Explosive Trap will kill all his minions besides a Violet Teacher. But that one will get killed either through the bash or the weapon. And at the Power of the Wild. Also a Doomsayer. Let's kill the Violet Teacher here. And I really like to play the Rage Unbound. Hit him for 7 in the face, and we are getting a minion. Shouldn't have any more Battlecry minions in the deck, so that's good. There's a Brave. And there's his Yogg-Saron. Let's see what he's doing. Hunter's Mark on the Brave. Evolve. Frostshock. At least the minions now can't attack. Shield Slam won't do anything. Demon Fire. Ooh, Soul of the Forest is good. A Swipe. Not killing any minions so far. And a Vanish, wow. So instead of the victory in our turn now, we need to play all our minions again. So are we playing the Rage Unbound or the Yogg-Saron? I'm not entirely sure how much more minions we have in the deck. So we might not get any value out of the Rage Unbound if we play him later on. So let's play him now. There should be Harrison Jones in the deck. Ah, another Acolyte of Pain. There is his Yogg-Saron again. Let's see, that's Mortal Strike. Hitting his Yogg. Enters a Colosseum. Holy Fire, hopefully hitting him again. No, that does on the hunt. And why would you kill our minion, please? Oh boy. And the Pyroblast. It will hit him, great. Oh, that was a great Yogg-Saron here. Let's see what we can do. We can play more stuff. Like the Violet Teacher, we have the Execute here. Want to save the Yogg-Saron for now and clear the board a bit. We are not in the danger of going down. The Emperor and the Raven Idol. Good stuff, good stuff. Also, where did that come from? Colosseum Manager, why would he play that? Well. Let's play the Yogg-Saron. Hopefully we are buffing our minions here and might win the game. Frostbolt, yeah, on the Yogg. Okay, the Yogg is gone. Savage Roar is great. And we're also getting Emperors in our deck. So the value of the Elise will increase. Mind Vision Healing Touch. So that's it. We can go to the face here. Let's draw another card. And the bash, so we are going to the face. Eye for an eye, okay. And we win the game. GG. If you have enjoyed the video, don't forget to subscribe and check out my other content as well. You can also follow me on Twitter and Twitch, as well as supporting me on patreon.com. Thanks for watching the video and see you soon.